have come rejoicing into the house of the Lord for this celebration. Now we stand with Marco and Aaron on the day they intend to form a home of their own. For them, this is a moment of unique importance. So let us support them with our affection, with our friendship, with our prayer as their brothers and sisters. Let us also listen attentively with them to the word that God speaks to us today. Then with Holy Church, let us humbly pray to God the Father, to Christ our Lord, for this couple, his servants, that he lovingly accept them, bless them, and make them always one. Let us pray. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness pour out your grace in these your servants, Karen and Marco, that coming together here before your altar, they may be confirmed in love for each other. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Please be seated. Our first reading from the Sacred Scriptures will be read by Laura.
How good is the Lord to all? How good is the Lord to all? The Lord is kind and full of compassion, slow to anger, abounding in mercy. How good is the Lord to all? Compassionate to all his creatures.
How good is the Lord to all?
All your works shall thank you, O Lord, and all your faithful ones bless you. The eyes of all look to you, and you give them their food in due season. The Lord is righteous in all his ways and holy in all his deeds. The Lord is close to all who call on him in truth. How good is the Lord to all?
The second reading will be read by Terry.
Reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only begotten Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In this is love. Not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation as our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God, yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is the word of the Lord.
Amen.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked and the disciples were for fear of the Jewish leaders, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Before my reflection, I want to say a word about that striking, handsome priest sitting behind the soon-to-be newlyweds. I know the family know very much who he is, but some of you may not. He is a priest of the church more than 58 years. He is the first cousin of Antonio, the deceased spouse of Audrey, the deceased dad of Marco and Roberto. And he was so privileged to baptize the groom and the best man. That was just a few years ago, right? And I've had numerous conversations with him over the last few months. He lives down in Bridgeport, diocese, and we are so delighted he's here. So please join me in welcoming to St. John the Evangelist today, Monsignor Matteo Bernardo. Carissimo Monsignore, siamo pieni di felicità. Se tu puoi essere qui in questa gioiosa occasione da matrimonio di Marco e Carmen, io spero che Monsignore ti darà tanti anni più, non solamente nel sacerdozio sacro, ma nella vita. Join me again and welcome to the I just asked him to forgive the errors I just made in Italian. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord from today's gospel. So you see all the red around. Today is the feast of Pentecost, tonight and tomorrow. The feast of the gift of the Holy Spirit. We must always remember that even after the resurrection of Jesus, in those days and weeks, the disciples' faith was weak. We see this over all the 14 Easter appearances, be it on the road to Emmaus, or at the empty tomb, or in the Sea of Galilee, in the upper room. Their faith was weak and faltering. And then 50 days after the resurrection, with tongues as a fire on their heads and the sound of a strong driving wind, the Holy Spirit came upon the apostles, and the birthday of the church began. What a beautiful feast, Karen and Marco, you chose to have your wedding. As the church was born on Pentecost, so your relationship of marriage is born in just a few minutes. So let's take a moment about gifts. We all give gifts on special occasions. Their gift, the gifts you will give them, gifts they are to each other, to all of us. And we take great pains, don't we, to find what gift, what card we're going to give to those we love. So today we take great pains to pray for Marco and Karen, that the same Holy Spirit that gave the early church a spiritual B12 shot will come upon them, will rush upon them, give them grace upon grace. The scriptures that they chose are just wonderful for this occasion. First reading that Laura read from the book of Genesis is all about the creation of man and woman and how they needed each other from the get-go. And then Roberto read the responsorial song, "How good the Lord is to all," and we are so conscious and aware today how good God has been in bringing Marco and Karen together. Finally, Terry read from the first letter of John, everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. That's what today's celebration is all about. The Holy Spirit, God dwelling, the divine dwelling, and the gift that they are to each other and to us. Now, for a good number of years, I've been asking couples in the weeks before marriage to write to me. Tell me about the relationship with each other. So I'm going to read first Robert's reflection and then Karen's after that. I'll give you a little sneak preview. One of the two was a lot longer than the other. But I'll leave it to you to figure out when they're both read, which I guess some of you may guess which one is longer. Anyway, so let's start with Marcos. When I think about what Karen means to me, I think about a theme throughout our relationship that has connected us in a very special way, traditions. Tradition comes from two Latin words, trahere, to pass down. Neighborhood traditions, ethnic traditions, family traditions, faith traditions, and personal traditions. Connecting with one another in and through traditions over the past 10 years has created a bond between Karen and me that goes beyond just our love for each other. Karen and I met through a chance introduction thanks to mutual friends. We were at the Steuben Day Oktoberfest in Central Park in 2012, 10 years ago. This is a traditional neighborhood festival that happens every year when I grew up in New York City in the Yorkville neighborhood. Yorkville, also known more contemporarily as the Upper East Side, was traditionally an area of German, Hungarian, and Czech influence. While the makeup of the neighborhood has changed dramatically over the years, its traditions still exist. It was into this tradition that Karen and I first met. It started, I believe, with one of my friends saying, "Talk to her, she is good people." It did not take a few seconds until Karen was able to determine that I had some sort of Italian heritage with a name like Marco. This caused me to use one of my old poor attempts at flirtation and pull out my New York State driver's license and better that, quote, my last name had more letters than hers did, end of quote. To my chagrin, she won by a significant margin, as I have 10 letters and she has 13. It was from this point that I think tradition already started to link us, and we had only just met. We spoke further that afternoon and toward the end of the day had another chance encounter coming out of the park at 72nd and 5th Avenue. It was here that we exchanged numbers. I was not living in New York City at the time, but told her that I would like to meet again, which we did before I had to fly back to Augusta, Georgia, a few days later when I was attending a class for the Army. While the rest is history, as they say, traditions continue to be a focal point of connection for us both. Ethnic traditions are another strong link that connects Karen and me when I think about what she means to me. My father immigrated to the U.S. from Italy in the 1970s, and after marrying my mother, established himself as a highly successful restaurant owner in New York City. Food, good wine, and hospitality were part of my family traditions for as long as I can remember. Karen had a similar appreciation for these from her Italian heritage. My father passed away in 2007, and Karen never had the opportunity to meet him formally. I think he had some role in our chance encounter in life, as, like my father, her appreciation to make others feel happy, cared for, or comfortable was something I see in her every day. Just after we met, I told Karen that my father had owned a restaurant called Divino in the neighborhood. Excuse me. He put the two words in there. Divino in the neighborhood for many years. And to my surprise, not only did she say she knew where it was, but that she had eaten there many years ago with family. There is an end to this at some point. Now you know it was a longer tour. I don't know if my father was at the restaurant that day, but I still like to think that he was, and that potentially he did cross paths with Karen years before we met. I was very happy to be able to take Karen several times to Divino before it closed, and we had dinner there, and the last night it was opened with several close family friends, a moment I will always remember. Another tradition is family. When I first met Karen, I told her if we were going to be together, she would need to learn some Italian, as my family in Italy does not speak English. What amazed me is she not only dedicated herself to learning, but also took pride in it and went to Italian classes for several semesters after her job each day. I have to admit I have done a poor job of practicing Italian with her because I am fluent, but to this day, it astounds me that I met a woman who would do such a thing. Karen has been to visit my family many times in Italy, but on one occasion we had a beautiful experience in particular. Karen's mother had given us some letters written by her parents in the 1970s and 1980s to her family in Puglia, Italy, which is in the far south of the heel of Italy. Over the years, they had lost contact with those family members, but still had multiple letters. I saw some of the letters, and I told Karen we should go to visit the Puglia region, and also tried to go to these addresses to find her family, as most people in Italy didn't move too far from their families. What we found still amazes me to this day. We found two parts of Karen's mother's family. Two older ladies who actually were Karen's mother's aunts, who she had never met. Karen's mother's aunts, excuse me, whom she never met. What made it even more memorable was that they all spoke Pugliese dialect, which is like speaking Arabic to me. As my father's from the north of it, we had a translation going on between three languages to understand one another, from Pugliese to Italian to English. Karen and I share some strong faith traditions. When we first met, it was clear that we were connected by our Roman Catholic heritage, and I appreciate the fact that Karen would come to weekly mass with me on a somewhat regular basis. When we got engaged, it was important for both of us to be married in the church. To our surprise, we really enjoyed our pre-Cana classes, even during COVID, when we would only do it virtually. We found that it connected us in many ways we had not expected. It made us talk about things we had never spoken of before, after 8 years plus of our relationship. It was important to us that the priest we wanted to have at our wedding had a connection in faith to our families. Father Doyle was Karen's childhood priest from St. Catherine's of Siena in Albany, and he was supposed to officiate today, but unfortunately was not able to be here due to health issues. We wish him the best for him for a speedy recovery. Monsignor Bernelli was here with us today as my dad's cousin, and he not only baptized me and my brother, but was present also at our communions and confirmations. These great traditions unite both of us and make our bond with each other, God, exceedingly strong. Finally, we come to personal traditions. I have served in the Army for over 22 years, which has always been an important part of my life. Karen embraced this from an early part of our relationship and sacrificed significantly. Well, I think there was a natural connection with Karen's father, Chip, who was drafted during the Vietnam era. Karen has always been a tremendous supporter of my military career. She has been such an amazing ally over the years. Through two deployments, Battalion Command, the Army War College, and now Brigade Command, she consistently has been at my side. While I have done a poor job of letting her know how much I appreciate her support, my success and the success of so many soldiers in my military career can be directly attributed to Karen's support. She is the most empathic, caring, and supportive person I know. The kaleidoscope of traditions that has been present in my lives has made our love for one another as solid as possible, and there is no one else I would want to walk the journey of life together with. Karen means the world to me, and I am humble and honored that she wants to walk this journey together. Now, before we read Karen's, see if I have the facts straight in my head. Roberto has given 22 years of service thus far in the United States Army. His brother Roberto, 17, the United States Marine, 39 years of service to our country. Thank you for your service. Okay, Karen, you're up to bat. Marco and I have met 10 years ago coming September. After all these years, our lives have had so become so intertwined that it's difficult to envision my life without her. Yet at the same time, I feel like those 10 years have gone by in an instant, and it seems like it can't be possibly that long since we met. Every year seems to go by faster than the last, but I can't imagine a better person to spend all my years with. We are fortunate that in this time, we have been able to fill our lives together with many amazing adventures. We've shared significant life events and milestones with each other, filled with hopes, dreams, and wonderful moments, as well as some painful and difficult times. My love for Marco grows stronger with each new experience and moment. I often have difficulty finding the words to express my love for those I care about, and don't always say it as much as I should. Marco always remembers to tell me that he loves me. His support and love have given me so much trust in him and our relationship, and I believe it allows me the ability to tell him how I love him and what he means to me. When things in life get overwhelming, I remember how lucky I am to have him in my life and to have someone by my side who cares so much about me. During these last few weeks before the wedding, I've been trying to take it all in, and I appreciate and enjoy every moment as I know it will all go by so quickly. I can't wait for what is next to come for us and what our next journeys will bring. Our relationship did not have a traditional start, as Marco was already scheduled to deploy to Africa for the Army for almost a year, just a few months after we met. Despite this, we continued to spend time together to get to know each other better. Even in the early stages, we both recognized how special our connection was to each other. Knowing the risks of distance, I just could not give up on the chance of what this relationship would become. I was willing to try and overcome that distance. His intended departure made the relationship at a quicker pace than usual, because we had to make good use of the time. I felt at ease and comfort with them right from the start. The relationship progressed and intensified, and before he left, he told me he loved me, that he wanted to continue our relationship while he was gone. I was concerned that I would not have the strength to maintain the kind of relationship, not to mention be able to provide this type of support needed for the demands of military career. But his faith in me helped me to give me the courage to pursue the relationship. The distance gave us the opportunity to get to know each other in a different way. He was able to communicate with me regularly when he was abroad, and his consistency and reliability with those communications were very important to me in helping cope with the distance. I look forward to hearing from him every day. It would make my heart so happy when one of his messages would appear. I knew that I was going to do everything I could to make it work. Of course, it was not always easy, not being with someone physically, especially during an argument or tough times, can make it seem harder to work through. But we were open and honest with each other and worked hard to resolve any issues. I knew that I could depend on Marco, which would be incredibly important to me. We learned more and more about each other, and through our conversations, I found out what a remarkable person he truly is. The circumstances gave us the opportunity to freely talk about our thoughts and concerns and learn more about each other early in the relationship. He helped bring out my ability to express my feelings, and I feel secure about sharing myself with him. When Marco returned home, my love for him was stronger than ever, and we were finally able to enjoy our relationship together and explore what could become. We planned so many things to do together. We even had been keeping a list of all the things we wanted to do when we came back. I don't remember how many of these things we really accomplished, but we had wonderful times with lots of fun and laughter. Marco likes to plan trips and adventures that has made so much more adventure than I ever was before. He gives me courage to try new things. We had also tried to adopt living life together while I was working full-time and pursuing my graduate degree. We had to remember to continue to make each other a priority. We were able to make the best of circumstances we had been through and use it for the positive and improve our communication skills. The military contains a large part of Michael's life, which takes up a lot of his time and has him out of town a lot. It is important to me that I was able to support him as best I can. It's not always so easy, but I try to remember what this support means to me, to him, and the greater goal the military life he has chosen. I know now how he values this part of his life. He's one of the hardest working people I know. While that may be difficult at times because of the amount of time devoted, I really admire this about him. And I genuinely appreciate all the support he gives me. His support gives me the confidence to pursue my goals and ambitions. I know I can accomplish so much with Mark on my side. Over the last 10 years, we've been through a lot together and shared many special moments and created many amazing memories. We truly enjoy each other's company and love spending time together. We love planning trips and traveling together. Mark was one of the most interesting and amazing people that I know, and I admire him for his strength and confidence. He gives me the security and comfort to express my thoughts and feelings without being judged. Mark was the most important person in my life. I look forward to spending the rest of our lives together. I love and appreciate Mark very much, and he means the world to me. Just a few minutes, a few words of Monsignor before I wrap this up. Monsignor, io sono stanco morto di leggere tutte queste cose, quindi domani puoi rimanere un altro giorno per dire tutte le mie tre lezioni, no? How many of you got that? I said, having read all that, I'm so exhausted, I'm asking the Monsignor to stay tomorrow so he can say all my three lessons. So, seriously, a beautiful sentence, it's obvious and powerful. And Karen, you know what a gift they are to each other. So continue to share the gift. Continue to deepen the love that already exists between you. Continue to look to your family, your friends, and all of your colleagues and neighbors and co-workers to support you. And most importantly, Karen, Marco, continue to make Christ Jesus the rock and foundation of your lives. Call upon God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and may the Holy Spirit again, with the Father, the Son, and the Lord, to come to you very specially in the sacrament of marriage. Bless you now and always. Amen. Dear Marco and Karen, you have come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of Monsignor and myself, the church's ministers, and the community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you through a special sacrament that enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever. In so all the responsibilities of married life, so in the presence of the church, Karen and Marco, I ask you to state your intentions. Have you come here to enter into the marriage of the church without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly? Are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live? And are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God, to bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church? Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, please join your right hand to declare your consent before God and his church. Marco, you take care of your lawful wife, to have it to call from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until death do you part. Karen, you take Marco to your lawful husband, to have him to call from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until death do you part. May the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the
And God, who joined together our first parents in paradise, strengthen and bless in Christ the consent you have declared before the church, so that with God joined together, no one can lose life. Lord, bless these prayers, which Karen and Marco will give to each other as a sign of love and fidelity.
Karen, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Reception, we have the opportunity to express that, but to preserve the dignity of our ceremony here in church, with applause and applause only, please. Let us now welcome and congratulate Mr. and Mrs. Karen, Mr. and Mrs. Marco, and Karen Mountjoy. To show now that having been joined in holy matrimony, they're going to light a candle, and the two moms lit the candles at the beginning to show the transmission of human life. And when they light the Christ candle, they will now tell us that we all know that now joined together in marriage, spiritually they are really no longer two. Lisa and Louis to go to the vestibule of church to bring the offertory gifts forward. the Almighty Father, show favor to our supplications, O Lord, and receive it with a kindly countenance. The oblations we offer for these, your servants, join now in a holy covenant, that through these mysteries they may be strengthened in love for each other and for you through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
Yes,
lift up your hearts.
Lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you will that the human race, created by the gift of your goodness, should be raised to such high dignity, that in the union of husband and wife, you might bestow a true image of your love. With those we created out of charity, you call to the law of charity without ceasing, and grant them a share in your eternal charity. So, the sacrament of holy matrimony is the abiding sign of your own love, consecrated the love of man and woman through Christ our Lord. Through him, the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please be seated or kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them the light that do fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Give you thanks that you have kept us worthy to be in presence and ministry. Humbly we pray that by taking on the body of Christ, we may be gathered to one by another. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Edward, our Bishop, and other Christians. And remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, especially the deceased member of their family, Antonio, Stefano, Charles, Thomas, and Paul, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all, we pray, that may the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced with your life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Please rise. At the Savior's command, before our divine teaching, we dare to say, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done.
but deliver us from it. Now let us unleash God's blessing upon this bridal groom, that in his kindness he may favor with himself those on whom he has bestowed the sacrament of matrimony. O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe, for man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable handmaid to the man, that they might no longer be two but one flesh, and thought that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery, that in the wedding covenant you foreshadowed the sacrament of Christ in this church, look with favor on this your servant, Marco and Karen, joined together in marriage, who has to be strengthened by your blessing, send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit, and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace of love and peace abide in you, daughter Karen, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May your husband entrust his heart to her, so that acknowledging her as his equal and his joy here to the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for the church. And now, Lord, we pray you, may your blessing, this your servant, hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments, made one in flesh, may they be blameless in all they do, and with the strength that comes from the gospel, may they bear true witness to Christ before us. And grant them, reaching at last together the fullness of the earth, for which they hope they may come to the life of blessing in the kingdom of heaven, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever. The peace of the risen and ascended Lord be with you. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Two lines on the center aisle. Please put your hands like this, like a cupcake. We ask you not to grab the host. Okay, like a cupcake, and then just consume it. And when you're done, return to your seat by way of the side aisles. Folks here, if you want to wait till you're all done, I'll go over to your community. And that's it. Okay? Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, that I am not worthy that you should be my but those thank you.
Please rise. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the power of the sacrament we have received may find growth in these your servants, that the effects of the sacrifice we have offered may be felt by us all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our Lord, carry your words in the book of Numbers, offers gratitude for St. Francis of Assisi. Lord, bless you and keep you. Lord, to this face we will be gracious to you. Lord, let them take confidence upon you and give you peace. Our Senior, please join me in the final blessing. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The celebration of holy matrimony is over. Let us go out in the love and peace of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You're going to go to the front of the altar and you're going to kiss. All right?
I love you more.